In this video, you'll learn how to create a business case for Azure using a free tool called Azure Migrate. To understand if Azure really makes financial sense, start by creating a business case with Azure Migrate. This helps you understand what the best migration strategy is for your business. To get started, go to the Azure Portal with your active Azure subscription and navigate to Azure Migrate. With Azure Migrate, you can see key migration goals where you need to click on Discover, Assess, and Migrate. You can use an existing Azure Migrate project or create a new project in the geography of your choice. You can either import your server inventory using a CSV file or discover your data center using an agentless appliance covering VMware, Microsoft Hyper-V, bare metal servers, as well as IaaS servers of other public clouds. For this demo, you'll see that discovery has already been completed, and we're ready to build a business case based on the rich data insights that have been captured. Next, click on Build Business Case and provide minimal inputs to get started. Give the business case a unique name and choose a target Azure location. You can provide a preferred migration strategy, which could be to minimize cost, migrate all to IaaS, and modernize to PaaS. Next, you can choose the savings options combination that you want to be considered. Choose reserved instances only if you have stable, predictable workloads with no planned changes. Choose reserved instances plus Azure savings plan if you want additional flexibility and automated cost optimization for dynamic workloads. Within a few minutes, the business case gets computed using your inputs and industry benchmarks and is ready for review. The overview report here is an executive summary of the business case. The first thing you see here is an estimated on-premise versus Azure TCO and the potential steady-state savings possible by getting rid of components that you'll no longer need. As you plan to execute your migration project over the next few years, you can see a more realistic year-on-year current versus future state costs. You can see the unique incentives that you get with Azure, along with your savings coming from Azure hybrid benefits by bringing your existing Windows and SQL Server licenses to Azure and extended security update savings from your end-of-support software. Based on the rich data insights found in the discovery process, you'll find how to effectively migrate to Azure, which over-provisioned servers and workloads to right size, and which unused servers to decommission. Next, you can see the detailed on-premise versus Azure total cost of ownership and find insights to what really is contributing to these savings for your compute, storage, network, security, IT labor, and facilities cost. You can dive deeper into the Azure IaaS and PaaS reports. IaaS reports will provide right-sized targets and most cost-effective offers based on your usage. You can also identify the impact of unused servers and identify quick wins through software end of support and for zombie servers. Similarly, in the PaaS reports, you can identify quick wins and the ideal right-sized targets for your database and application workloads. Given the importance of what-if scenarios and customizations in this process, you can override default assumptions and build a business case for your migration strategy. You can also export this business case in an Excel workbook for further review. And finally, you can present the case to all stakeholders, get buy-ins, and know that you have taken the right steps for your business. Create your first business case with Azure Migrate today.